The Prophet ﷺ got up and gave a talk. It must be very important. It was an extremely important talk. Short, sweet, to the point. What did he say? I want to know that. Virtue of Arafah, the khutbah. Up to this day in Arafat, the khutbah happens. On the day of Arafah, the Imam gets up and he gives a talk, reminding the Muslims about their duties unto Allah. So what did the Prophet ﷺ say? The first thing he spoke about was blood. Don't spill the blood of each other. Don't murder each other. Don't commit murder. Your blood is sacred, more sacred than the Kaaba. Subhanallah. Your blood is sacred, more sacred than the Kaaba. Your blood is sacred, more sacred than this day. Your blood is sacred, more sacred than this place. Your blood is sacred, more sacred than Mecca, more sacred than Arafat, more sacred than the condition. Or the hadith actually says, كَحُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا. Similar to the prohibition, similar to the sanctity of this place. So in the same way, life is also sacred, as sacred as the place. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Number one, don't commit murder. My brothers and sisters, that means solve your problems, work with each other, learn to respect each other, have a big heart, learn to forgive each other. Imagine, here is the Nabi. Here is the Prophet, the most beloved, the one who is the leader. And he's telling us in his final pilgrimage to say, you are all my followers. You're all my ummah. Don't kill each other. May Allah grant us a lesson. Don't fight each other. Don't kill each other. No. Inna dima'akum. What else? Wa amwalakum. Don't steal from each other. Don't deceive each other in business. Don't shortchange each other. Watch out, your wealth. Don't usurp the wealth of another. Don't. Subhanallah. So your life and your wealth is all sacred. The wealth of each other is sacred. I can't steal someone else's things. I will pay a heavy, heavy penalty. In fact, if I were to kill someone, it is as though I've killed entire humanity. And if I were to steal from someone, I have committed such a heavy crime that I don't even know if I'm going to be forgiven. These are the basic elements of existence. And he mentioned them on the day of Arafah. That's what Arafah is all about. Ponder over how you look at others. Solve your matters. Watch how you treat people. Be careful. Your wealth, other people's wealth, sacred. Don't steal, don't pinch, don't deceive. Don't cheat, don't shortchange. Subhanallah. Then you're a Muslim. Then you're a true believer. And he says thereafter, he goes on and on. He speaks about dima'akum wa amwalakum wa a'radakum. You know, don't even insult one another. Don't demean each other. Don't belittle each other. Accuse each other falsely. Be careful. All this he made mention of. And he repeated it on the day of Eid as well. He repeated it during the days of slaughter and sacrifice. He repeated the same words. This khutbah has been repeated more than once by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with various wordings. And on the day of Arafah, he said something amazing. Do you know what he says? He said, everything that was of the period of ignorance, I'm putting it under my feet, it no longer is valid. What does that mean? All the ignorance, the way they treated women, what they did, all the cultural things that were so taboo and so silly. He says, under my feet, thrown. Racism was part of Jahiliyyah, thrown. All of this thrown, it is finished, no more. Let's ask ourselves, racism, tribalism, nepotism. Wow, nepotism. Isn't that alive and healthy in some communities, in many communities? Astaghfirullah. If we're believers, here is the messenger on the day of Arafah saying, watch out. No racism. All the jahiliyyah, kick it out. Don't maltreat women. Jahiliyyah, kick it out. So don't think you're superior. Jahiliyyah, kick it out. Learn to respect people. Imagine there were revert Muslims on that day. Who were the reverts? Every single one of them were reverts. Do you know that? Nowadays, the strange thing is we won't even allow our daughters to marry a revert or our sons to marry a revert, and we claim we come from the family of the Prophet. Well, here is the same Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling you racism is out, tribalism is out, nepotism is out. All these isms are out, totally, completely kick them out. It's jahiliyyah. usurping the wealth of another, insulting, false accusation, all out. Subhanallah. May Allah grant us goodness. Superstition, all of that is gone out. Don't engage in magic. All that was part of Jahiliyyah. So it's right for us to mention it here today. Kicked out. Then he spared a moment to talk about women. What did he say? He said, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِي النِّسَىٰ. Fear Allah regarding your treatment of women. When did he say this? The day of Arafah. I remember speaking to a sister not long ago, and she told me, when I read what the Prophet ﷺ said about the day of Arafah, I would have called it Women's Rights Day, subhanAllah, because he made it clear, saying, fear Allah regarding the treatment of women. Who are the women? Your daughters. Watch out. Watch out. Don't be unfair. Your sisters. Be careful. The Prophet ﷺ warns you about it. Who else? Primarily your spouses. They've given up their families to come to you. How do you treat them? Subhanallah. How do you talk to them? How do you make them feel? اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِي النِّسَىٰ. Fear Allah regarding the women. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly tells us this in the surah known as Surah An-Nisa. Allah tells us to fear Allah and to fear the wombs that gave birth to, subhanAllah, the women in a nutshell. So he says, he goes on, he gives a little bit more detail. Do you know what he says? He says, you married the women using the name of Allah, so fear Allah how you treat them. Oh, whoa, whoa. Here he's speaking to the married men. Watch out. Those women, you use the name of Allah. You use the name of Allah to take them, to marry them. Treat them well. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ says, the best from amongst you are those who are best to their wives. This is the day where the women were empowered by Islam. Subhanallah. They felt so proud of what was being said. And I'm sure they will be to this day. Extremely proud. This is the day of Arafah, the greatest day of the entire year, according to a lot of the scholars. The greatest day. I told you, the nights are different. The day, subhanAllah. Some say the day of Nahr, the day of Arafah. You know, if you look at the freedom from hellfire, it's the day of Arafah, subhanAllah. So, the Prophet ﷺ telling us, watch out, be careful. The best from amongst you, those best to their wives. And then he says, you must make sure you take care of them, provide for them, give them their clothing, give them their food, give them their shelter, and so on. Remember how you treat them. And this is why we say, my brothers and sisters, whether it's your mother, your grandmother, your aunt, your sister, your child, your spouse, your grandchild, your niece, whoever it may be, or a strange woman. Here is the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After the women were treated so unwell, and after they were actually bought and sold and traded as a commodity, he says, all of that is prohibited on this day. All of it. You treat them well, and the best from among you, those who are best to their wives. My brothers, I don't think you really expected this to come out of the day of Arafah, did you? But subhanAllah, it's a fact. And it has come out. One of the virtues of the day of Arafah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the lecture, the amazing historic khutbah of Arafat that was a part of the Hajj that was delivered in the farewell pilgrimage by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.